Welcome to FedRAMP in 5, where we discuss all things FedRAMP in about 5 minutes. Today's topic, database vulnerability scanning. Cha-ching. What do you think?
Well, you know, this has been one of those issues that has come up a lot,
yeah.
Right? Like vulnerability scanning itself, you know, is a critical part of getting and maintaining an ATO. Absolutely critical. You have to do it well. You have to have good processes. You have to maintain your plan of action and milestones, which is, you know, fed out of that process. So you have to do it well. But thankfully, you know, vulnerability scanning has been done for years. It's well understood. There are plenty of tools. There's a lot of know-how. So it's not really a mystical thing. But I think some of the complexity here comes in from it's a bit of a different way that FedRAMP wants you to organize your scanning process, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So they want to understand, you know, your infrastructure scans, your web app scans, and your database scans. Those are the three things.
Yep.
So, yeah, I mean, among those, like, infrastructure is very, very straightforward, right?
It is well known. I mean, you know, it's a scan your Windows host, scan your Linux host, enumerate those vulnerabilities, patch them, vendor dependencies, you know, move on.
Yep.
Very, yeah,
I mean, they want
very
like an authenticated scan, yep. But aside from that, you know, that's not hard to yep. do either.
Web app scanning, you know, taking a look at those exposed APIs or those exposed web servers that are out there serving requests and making sure that they're secure, that there's, you know, making sure that, you know, the OWASP top 10 are being protected against, you know, stuff like that. So those are fairly standard and solid. But whenever it comes to a database scan, as in, you know, what does exactly that mean? You know, I have a database stood up on a host somewhere, and I ran an infrastructure scan, and it saw a MySQL server running on 3306, and it's like, oh, I'm scanning my database. I'm done.
Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, because you drive by it in the infrastructure scan,
yep.
It sees it. It probably even sees like which version it is, yep. And it sees that, oh, there's no patches for that version. So does that mean I scan my database because I scan the infrastructure that it's on? You know, it's,
yeah.
A lot of people think, well, is that a database scan?
No.
Let's unpack that. Let's unpack. I don't think that that's a database scan.
Yeah, yeah.
So yep. Just to be clear, right? So a database scan is really, you have a database port.
Mm-hmm.
You've got credentials for the database server,
yep.
Privilege credentials.
Yep.
And then you have a scanner with a plugin specifically for that database.
Yep. Yep.
Right. And it knows how to go in and interrogate that database.
Yep. Yep.
Right. And you know, it looks for common misconfiguration. It's like a configuration scan, really.
Yep. 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 So, you know, that's explaining what a database scan actually is. What about the shared responsibility model in the cloud, you know, especially when it comes to like Amazon RDS or Amazon AWS RDS or something like that,
mm-hmm.
you know, where something, part of it is managed by somebody else, you know, you're using a managed service, so you offload that risk. It's like, well, you know, how does that look in security of the cloud versus in the cloud?
Yeah.
What is that?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's the expectation, right? Like, that's why I'm leveraging a managed service, so I don't have to patch it, I don't have to scan it, I don't have to do all that stuff.
Yep, yep.
But from what we've seen in practicality, that may not be the expectations of FedRAMP, and we'll get into that
exactly.
Yep. In a minute.
And then another topic is, you know, yeah, we're using that managed service, but we can enumerate these things, but we have no way of fixing them. You know, what do we do about it? You know,
that buried in a conf file that I can't even get to, right? Because
yep,
exactly. I don't have shell access to the server that it's running on.
Yep.
But only AWS has that.
Yep.
So what about that, right?
Yeah, yeah. So those are a couple of the problems. So let's get in and answer that one about the database scan. So, you know,
demystifying database scan.
So second, another one. So yeah, so basically, a lot of your well-known scanners, Nessus, Qualys, you know, just to name a few, have database plugins. You go into the configuration of a scan, you put in the proper port number, you put in privileged, privileged credentials that have the access in order to enumerate those, you know, SQL statements to generate that output to say, okay, well, you know, this one, this configuration doesn't look secure. This configuration does look secure. So it can actually answer that question and interrogate that. So
yeah,
that's really one of the things of being able to use a well-known scanner to go in and interrogate those things. That's what a database scan really looks like.
So but it doesn't include like all the other ports that are running on that server.
Yes,
so if SSH exactly. is open and all that, that, so really you should scan that port twice, once in the infrastructure scan, right? With the, you know, if it's not a managed service,
right?
Because you don't have to with RDS, right? You shouldn't do an infrastructure scan.
Oh yeah.
Against an RDS database. You can't do that.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you can do a database scan.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, exactly. Exactly. And then whenever it comes to that shared responsibility model of, okay, so I can enumerate these things, you know, I have that level of privilege to change those SQL commands, run those SQL commands to remediate it. So where exactly, you know, how does the cloud service provider like Amazon or Azure, how do they define that? You know, what is, do we have any guiding posts or what have we learned or what did we have to run into in order to get to that answer?
Right.
You
know? Yeah. So, I mean, I think that, you know, one of the things is AWS has done a good job at, you know, recently at describing what the responsibilities are
mm-hmm.
and how that lies.
Yep. Yeah.
So, you know, now it's well understood that, you know, you do need to scan an RDS database. That's part of your responsibility.
Yeah.
And if you actually look at the output of the database scan, like in the remediation notes, a lot of those things are just SQL commands
yeah.
that you can, you know, you can run the SQL command against the database port with the right credentials
mm-hmm.
to affect the configuration change that's recommended by the scan result. Even in cases where you can't, say if you run into something that, gosh, I can't change this,
mm-hmm.
you know, this is a finding against RDS, I can't change it because I don't have the right access. I mean, what do you do in that case?
Well, that would have to be a vendor dependency where we've found out.
So you'd have to report it up to AWS, put it in your POAM as a vendor dependency, perhaps, you know, and sort of manage it that way.
Yep. Yeah. So, yeah, going back to what you were saying about AWS specifically saying, you know, here's what you can and can't do. They have released a pen test guidance link on their AWS menu.
It's been out for
AWS
a while.
Pages. Yeah. That really, really clearly sets the expectation of what the customer can and can't do. So going back to what you were saying on that, I think that was a very eye-opening thing, seeing that and looking through that documentation. Extremely helpful.
Absolutely. So don't be afraid to scan your RDS databases. For databases like Dynamo, there's just no way to do it.
Yep.
Just due to the nature of DynamoDB, the fact that it's not an Aurora or MySQL instance that's actually running, it truly is a managed service, and that's on AWS to make sure that that stuff is done correctly and secure, right?
Exactly.
So, you know, look to your vendor, your IaaS provider, your PaaS provider for what they recommend, and hold their feet to the fire on it. Is our recommendation.
You can also look to us as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. So yeah, this is FedRAMP at 5. This is a quick hit on a topic. We know there are going to be other nuanced questions, so feel free to contact us at www.infusionpoints.com.